Hello. So today's video, we're going to be talking about teaching English in Spain. Spain is one of the most popular places to teach English in Europe because there are so many options for you. You can work at a language school, you can work with different kinds of programs, or you can work for a school directly. So if you want to know more about what it's like to teach in Spain and how you can do it, keep watching. First things first, let's talk a little bit about lifestyle. So, what is it like teaching English in Spain? What kind of lifestyle can you expect? Like with most countries, the biggest difference that you'll see in culture is between big cities and smaller towns and villages. So, of course, in a bigger city, you have more access to an international community, and it's less likely that you need to speak the local language, in this case, Spanish. So, if you live in a Madrid or Barcelona, it's much less likely that you will need a functional level of Spanish. You can probably get by speaking no Spanish or just using Google Translate and you'll be fine. However, if you do choose to go to a smaller town or village, or you pick a smaller town or village, you probably need to speak some level of Spanish or start taking lessons when you arrive. It's much less likely that the local population will speak English, and it's highly recommended that you have a functional level of Spanish so that you can do some of the bureaucratic things like finding an apartment, opening up a bank account if you need to, and things like that. It will be far less likely that people will speak English. So if you do live in a smaller town or village, be prepared for a more conservative way of life and a way of life that includes a fair amount of Spanish. So, one of the other benefits of working in Spain is that the cost of living is pretty low, especially considering other European countries like maybe France and Germany. The cost of living in Spain is really low, and that includes things like rent, food, and things like that. Even travel is a bit less expensive in Spain. However, with a lower cost of living comes with, in general, a lower salary. So, as an English teacher, whether you do a program or you're working with the school directly, your average salary will be somewhere between $800 US and maybe $1,300 US. So, it depends on the experience that you have already as an English teacher, whether you are in a big city or a smaller town. So, you can expect a higher salary if you live in a place like Madrid compared to a small town. So, you will get a higher salary living in a bigger city. But in general, you're probably not going to make more than $1,300 a month. That could be before or after taxes, depending on the institution or the program that you're working for. So, Spain is not really a savings country. You'll live very comfortably as an English teacher, but don't expect your savings account to balloon while you're working there, unless you take on private students, which is fairly easy to do in Spain. But in general, teaching English, you will only be able to live comfortably, but you're not going to pad your savings account. One of the other things that might be a bit of culture shock about the lifestyle in Spain is, of course, the siesta. Siestas are large breaks in the day. And what this means as an English teacher is if you are working for a school, it means that you'll have a very long lunch break, sometimes 2 to 3 hours of a lunch break. And while this sounds pretty great, it means you can go home, you can cook from home, you can go to a restaurant, you can take a nap, you can, do whatever you like. It's your free time usually. But what this means is that everything is kind of pushed back during the day. So you have this rather long, kind of luxurious break in the middle of the day, but just keep in mind that most things will be closed during that day. So it's not as if you can run to the post office or run errands or get things done as you would like to, because most businesses and offices are closed during that siesta day and you have to go back to work at the end of it, which means that the work day is much later. So, whereas if you have a regular 9 to 5 with just an hour lunch break, you can expect to be out of there by 5 o'clock. Oftentimes in Spanish schools, especially if you're teaching older kids or adults, because of the siesta, you come back at around 3 o'clock and then you still have 3 or 4 hours of teaching. So you might expect for your day to end a bit later. And of course, that means that dinner is a bit later. And going out, if you are going to go to a bar or a club, everything is kind of pushed back to be a lot later. So it's very common to eat dinner around 9:30, 10 o'clock, 10:30. That's a really common time to eat dinner. So it might be a bit of an adjustment. One of the options you have working in Spain is, of course, working at a language school. So language schools are institutions, they're usually private schools that take students of all ages to learn a specific language, in this case, English. So at a language school, you can have anything from kids on up to adults of varying levels. You'll have smaller classes of anywhere from one-on-one students all the way up to maybe 10 students in a classroom. Now, because Spain is a Western European country, working at a language school is almost exclusively for people who have a UK passport or a European passport. So if you do not have a European passport, it's really unlikely that you will be able to teach at a language school, because that means that the school has to sponsor you for your work visa. And honestly, they usually don't want to go through the hassle of hiring someone who needs a sponsorship for their visa, because they can hire someone from England or Ireland who already has a European passport and they don't have to deal with the hassle. What will happen after Brexit is a little bit unsure, but as things stand right now, to work at a language school, it's best that you have a European passport. As I mentioned before, the cost of living is quite low and your salary is quite low. So, working in a language school, you can expect to make anywhere from 1,000 euros on up to about 1,300 euros a month. And that could be with or without taxes included. So, if it's without taxes included, take off about 100 euros. Most language schools don't offer help with accommodation or anything like that, so you will be on your own as far as finding an apartment goes. As I said before, this can be made a lot easier if you are in a bigger city where it's much more likely that more people speak English. But if you're in a smaller town, having a functional level of Spanish could be really, really helpful to you as you try and find an apartment and things like that. If you want to work at an actual school, so an elementary, middle, or high school, you should probably have a teaching certificate or even a teaching degree from your home country. So those are usually reserved for people who have a little bit more experience, and you can expect a higher pay rate if you do work for a school, and you also get more benefits working for a school. They might pay for your insurance, and they might have bonuses worked into their system and things like that, but they are usually reserved for people who have a little bit more experience in teaching. Let's talk about programs. The option to work with a program is one of the reasons why Spain is such a popular country to teach English in. When you work with the program, they essentially find the school for you. So you apply to the program and they will put you in touch with the school. They also help with a lot of other things that you'll have to do to move to Spain. They will explain the visa process to you, help you understand what to do to get your visa, and depending on the program you choose, they might even help you with accommodation. So the first program I'm going to talk about is MEDIAS. When you work with MEDIAS, you'll be placed with an elementary, middle, or high school, and you might be placed anywhere in Spain. You don't really get a say. I believe that you can mention a preference, but there's no guarantee that this preference will be honored. So you'll work at a private school. You only need to work 20 to 24 hours a week. So you're not working a full-time schedule and you'll have a lot of free time. To work with MEDIAS, you will need a bachelor's degree. That bachelor's degree can be in anything, and you don't need to have any teaching experience, and you don't need to speak Spanish to work with MEDIAS. The great thing about Medeus is if you do have teaching experience or a TEFL or a CELTA or something like that, you will get more money. So they have a really cool graded program where if you have the lowest level of experience or no experience, you'll make less money. But if you do have more experience, which includes having a master's degree in TESOL or a master's in linguistics, you'll make a significantly more money. So there's three levels to the programs that they have. Another great thing about Medeus is if you're really interested in Spanish culture, you have the option to stay with a host family. So if you stay with the host family, they'll put you in contact with them. And of course, you don't have to worry about paying rent. If you stay with the host family, you'll be making less money. So for example, if you're at the highest level, meaning you have a master's degree or some years of teaching experience, you can expect to make somewhere around 900 to 1,000 euros per month, depending on what city you live in. That's if you choose to live in independent housing, which means you'll be responsible for finding your own apartment. However, if you're at the most advanced level and you live with the host family, you'll be making about half that, so somewhere between 400 and 500 euros a month. When I did the Medeus program, I did live with a host family, and I was a bit worried about having only 400 euros to live on. However, living with the host family, you really won't spend your money on anything. You should not pay for all of your own food. You take most meals with the family, and they pay for really a lot of things. So living with the host family is a really great option. Of course, you'll be in there with your host family, and usually the host family will have children, and those children go to the school that you teach at. So you can make really great relationships, and it's a really great experience living side by side with people from a different culture. If you do want to learn Spanish or Catalan or Basque, depending on where in Spain you actually are, living with the host family is a great option. Of course, there are drawbacks to living with a host family. You lose a certain amount of independence. Depending on the kind of accommodation that the host family has, you might be sharing a bathroom with one of your host siblings. This really depends on the kind of host family that you are placed with. You never quite know what you are going to get, and you never quite know the expectations the host family will have with you. Usually, this is something that you spell out with the host family, assuming that they speak English. That is another thing that you might run into. Your host family might not speak very much English. And they might have expectations of you, such as no overnight guests or even having a curfew. Now, this is something that doesn't happen with every host family, of course, but it is something that you have to think about as you are staying in their home with their children. They might, you know, kind of impose rules upon you. So I always think if you're going to do one of these programs, it's always best to do it if you're a little bit younger. So if you're used to living with roommates, if you're used to even living with your parents, being a host in a host family is not that much of a change from you. If you are older, if you've been living on your own, if you kind of like keeping your independence and your privacy and your own schedule, living with the host family might not be the best option for you because you will lose a certain amount of independence. Let's talk about some of the mechanics of how the Medeus program actually works. Their interview process is more extensive than you would expect for some language programs. So you'll want to apply while you're still in your home country because the application process will happen while you are still in your home country. First, you'll apply directly to them online. You'll give them your qualifications, your bachelor's degree, things like that. After you pass this stage, you'll have a phone or Skype interview with a teacher or someone who works at the Medeus head office. If you pass that interview stage, then you will have an in-person interview. These are arranged in your home country, and it depends on where you live. If you live in a big city like New York or LA, there will be no problem to find a person to go and speak with for your in-person interview. If you live in a less populated state or a less populated area, there's a chance you might need to travel for your in-person interview, and this is not reimbursed by Medeas. So you might have to travel for your interview. After that, that is when the placement is made. So you'll get accepted into the program, and you might have to wait maybe a month up to 2 or 3 months before you get your placement. And in that time, that's when you'll apply for your visa. Now, the visa situation is interesting with Medeas. Because essentially you will be working. However, because of the way that the visa system will work and the kind of loophole they've discovered, is you won't have a working visa. You will go to Spain on a student visa. Now, this actually means, in the case of Medeas, that you will be a student. So with Medeas, you will get a certificate of some kind at the end of your time there. So you'll take online classes with a accredited Spanish university. Your classes will be in English, so no worries there. And these classes can be anything from just a basic TOEFL course on up to things that are more advanced, like a plurilingual education, things that might actually help you in your English teaching career. The classes are not difficult. They're nothing you have to worry about. There are very few tests. Usually it's written assignments and kind of doing research on what it means to be an English teacher in an ESL context. You will have to take these classes, and you do need to pass the classes to pass through the program. So if you don't pass your classes, you might have some issues. You might have your pay delayed until you can kind of figure out how to pass your classes. That being said, they're very easy, and they actually do support you depending on how much experience you have as an English teacher. So when you get your student visa, it means that, of course, you can stay longer than the 3 months you can on a tourist visa. When you arrive in Spain, even after you have your student visa, you should report to the local police station, and this will end the visa process. That means that you are good and legal to stay in Spain. One of the really nice things about the Medeas program is if you like the school that you're placed with, you can extend for another year. Usually people don't extend more than 2 years. Unfortunately, let's say that you really liked the school that you were in, but you had a host family and you'd like to stay with your school, but maybe try independent living. That's not really an option because the contracts and the agreements work with the host family and the school in tandem. So you kind of have to go by, if you like the school, you have to stay with the host family, and vice versa. If you like the school and you were living alone and you think you'd like to try living with the host family, that's not really an option. So depending on whether you are living independently or living with your host family, that's kind of tied to the school. And if you do want to extend your contract, your living circumstances will stay the same. Because you're on a student visa, your pay is actually called a stipend. And Medeas is really great because they pay on time, they will help you with opening up a bank account, and they will transfer the money into your bank account. There isn't necessarily a program fee associated with Medeas, but there is a deposit. That deposit is about 400 to 500 euros, and you need to send it right after you receive your placement, before you actually head off to Spain. And this is a refundable deposit. And what it kind of does is just ensures that you're going to fulfill your working contract with the school. It's kind of their insurance against people who just decide they don't like it and they leave without fulfilling the year-long school contract that they fulfilled. So that deposit you will get back once you have completed your coursework and your full placement with your school. So that is a refundable deposit that you'll get back, and it will be paid into your bank account, into your Spanish bank account. And as I said before, Medeas has a great reputation for paying on time. Unfortunately, you will have to pay for the fees associated with your student visa. For the US, that's about $150 to apply for your student visa, and they also don't cover travel expenses. So you were on your own for getting yourself from your home country to Spain. Now let's talk about the other very common and popular program that's run in Spain. And this is similar to Medias, but this is run by the Ministry of Education of Spain. And they also have a language assistant teaching program. So much like Medias, you will be applying for a student visa, and this is just because it's much easier to recruit teachers who are not EU passport holders, so they don't have to sponsor a work visa. They recruit you as a student and you receive a stipend even though you are working. Now, unfortunately, the ministry-run language teaching program does not have the best reputation. They kind of are known for teachers being paid late and being disorganized. Now, this is highly dependent on the school you get and things like that, but in general, from kind of the top of the organization, you get less help, less handholding. There are more placements with the ministry-run program. So whereas Medias, there's about 300 to 500 placements a year for teachers. In the ministry-run program, there are thousands of placements, I think up to about 3,000 placements around Spain for the ministry program. The pay is also a little bit less. So for the ministry program, you can expect anywhere from 800 to 1,000 euros, depending on where you live. And this is not taxed at all, which is a benefit of the ministry program. They do not help you with accommodation, and you don't have the option to live with the host family with the ministry-run program. As I said before, they have not a great reputation among ESL teachers. The pay is often late and it's often disorganized. You might not have the most communication. They help you with insurance, but other than that, you're kind of on your own. Your experience will really be dependent on the kind of school that you get placed with. One benefit of the ministry program is that you work less hours. So you're only working about 12 hours a week in school, and that includes kind of doing administrative work like lesson planning. With the ministry program, you will be more of a language assistant, which means that you won't ever be alone in the classroom with the students, usually. Legally, you should not be alone with the class in the classroom with your students. So because it's not necessary to have any kind of training or prior experience teaching English, you'll usually be helping out in the classroom. Whereas with the Medias program, again, depending on your level, you might be only helping out in the classroom. Or if you do have some experience or a TEFL certification or something like that, you might be able to break out into smaller groups with your students and be able to teach small groups on your own. But that again is dependent on your level. So briefly, let's compare and contrast these two programs. With both programs, you are responsible for your flight to and from your home country, and you're also responsible for applying for your visa on your own, and you'll have to pay for your visa on your own as well. And with both programs, your experience will be highly variable. It really depends on, in the case of Medias, whether you live with your host family, whether you get along with your host family, and whether you get along with the teachers at your school, and that's for both programs. So you can do further research online and you'll see things run the gamut from, I loved my host family, we got along, we still keep in touch, we send each other Christmas cards, to, I hated my host family, I'm 24 years old and they made me have a curfew and I couldn't have any friends over and it was not a good experience. So it truly depends on the kind of experience you get on an individual level at your school, and that will really determine how your experience of teaching in Spain goes. And that is the case for both programs. I would say the pros of Medias is that it's a very well-organized institution. You do get to have a fun certification at the end of it, which actually will help you in the classroom. So if you are a little bit more serious about your English teaching career and prospects after you finish your program in Spain, Medias might be the best option for you. If you want a little less responsibility, the ministry-run program might be best for you. You'll only be in the classroom for 12 hours a week, so you'll have a lot of free time. However, with that comes a little less money. That money might also be late, and it's with a lot of disorganization. So the stress that you might feel and waiting for an email for something that might be pretty important, like figuring out your insurance, or if you have a problem with your school, you might not get a lot of support from the organization themselves. So those are kind of the pros and the cons of working with these two programs. Hopefully this video was helpful for you in choosing how you want to start your teaching career in Spain, whether you choose MEDIAS or the Ministry of Education's language program, or if you decide to work with a language school or middle, high school, elementary school. Check out the description below if you need any more information. There will be links to relevant programs.